Amazon will start delivering groceries from Whole Foods through its Prime Now service. Customers in Austin, Cincinnati, Dallas, and Virginia Beach will be the first to get the new service. Amazon will expand it across the country later this year. Prime members can get their orders delivered in 2 hours for free. A one-hour option will cost $7.99 on orders of $35 or more.
Now, wait a minute, because I'm a little excited about this.
Okay.
Is this going to be the whole inventory? So, like, you know, in other words,
I think so.
Or is it just because they have the 365 products on Amazon now, but that's, you know, that's just like some box cereal and
No, this is they're actually delivering from the stores.
That's pretty
wrong?
Cool.
That's what
I'm wondering. Yeah, because there's a huge difference, obviously, logistically. They have to have the refrigerated trucks and all that for the produce. And
this is like Fresh Direct with Whole Foods. But you know that you could get Whole Foods prior by using...
By walking into the store?
No,
yeah, it's the other service.
Postmates.
Instacart?
Or Instacart.
Yeah.
Instacart.
But that felt like, okay, another thing you have to sign up for and then go through the whole rigmarole. This, if you already have it and they make it pretty seamless...
It's the promise of Amazon.
I'm pretty excited. We'll see. LG Electronics plans to raise prices of its washing machines in the U.S. Get this, about 4 to 8% in response to those tariffs imposed by the Trump administration on large imported residential washers. LG says it plans to focus on sales of its high-end washers. Those are the ones priced over $900. Samsung is also affected by the tariff, and it says it is still reviewing the impact.
Okay, BlackRock reportedly raising $10 billion as part of a new business that would take direct stakes in companies, according to Reuters, and could put BlackRock in direct competition with companies like Berkshire Hathaway, and I would even argue more importantly, private equity firms like Blackstone. $10 billion is more like a private equity
But it is a different approach. I mean, if you're going to go and basically passively kind of buy and own a company, that's different from what private equity is doing.
Right. This is sort of like an actively managed.
It's more like saying we acknowledge this company works and we want to own it, as opposed to private equity, which I feel like says this company could be optimized.
Right.
Therefore, we want to own it and then sell it down the road.
Hey there. Thanks for checking out CNBC on YouTube. Be sure to subscribe to stay up to date on all of the day's biggest stories. You can also click on any of the videos around me to watch the latest from CNBC. Thanks for watching.